The signal can go. Oh. Then it will leave this way. Here are depot. And here, while this train is waiting here, there can be a second train waiting. Let's do one extra here. I will still build a line depot here. So if there's more than two trains here, one can wait in the depot. Here an exit depot, so it is freshly maintained when it comes from the line. I hope that all this works. So this one needs to go here. This is why I built the track so far apart. You can just go like this. And over here, instead of building over both of them and then making a big loop, like the standard tactic goes, let's build two lengths curve here. Man, S curves don't lower the speed much, and my top speed is in any case not much lower than the 88 I get from a minimal length curve. The real minimal length curve would give me around, I don't even remember, I think it's 55 or something, but there's an option to turn it off altogether, which I did, which makes the game more realistic and some traffic planning more easy because of the way it influences pathfinding. I didn't place signals here? Really? Okay. Let's turn the electric stuff off and place these signals. This might have been funny. The signals here mainly influence the speed of the trains. That is, between two signals there can obviously only be one train. So if the signals are further apart, the trains have to drive further apart. And if there is a change in signal spacing, then the trains have to wait at this place, at that place. Now, before the line enters the main station, there needs to be a block of depots here. Maybe it would even be better if I double the line here. Oh yeah, this will be complicated because of the crossing here. So let's add some more stuff here. Tunnel here. Is this an... Yes, it's electric, good. Geht's elektrik. Now let's leave for depot here. Make a waiting line. Entry, exit over here. And let's go up there. So here come pass signals. I will show you why. Later we can make the depots pretty. This here continues here. We make a crossover here again. Now we have a double line. The simplest type. It's not very effective. This one I can't build. Pity. What I should do is break this here and build over here, so it enters here. directly. Can I build this? Yes, I can. Cool. Let's build this. So here. Then this one here needs to be a pass signal. Here, this one needs to be risen a bit. I did it wrong. We remove this. And go here. Down. Up. Normally, most people recommend against bridges, but if I'm playing with a train set like this, which has very... Well, yes, very, very, what was I gonna say? Very slow freight trains in any case. It doesn't make much difference. A little bit more signals for this line and this line. Just random. We need an exit to here maybe. No, not really. Don't know which way is they're going. I hope. This might cause some trains to go this way and then take the route through the station. But this part is not really full these days. Not really full. Because jams are mainly here on this single line. Second line, I could merge it in here. This would work. But how? What is best in life? Maybe rise up. No, this doesn't work either. Lower this. No, this can't work either. So they can only enter here. This is bad. Difficult. No. Pass auf. Can I make a bridge here? No. A bridge here? I can. I didn't even notice that you can do this. Okay. Build a bridge over another bridge. Really? Cool. Oh, this makes things a lot easier. Then we add a crossover here, another one. Pass signals in the right places. Then the whole thing can go this way too. No, this would break it. So here. Then we can enter from here. This is a little bit strange. I hope this works. Those S-curves don't slow the trains much, unless you have really too much of them. This ends up here. This would be okay, in fact. Trains can wait there and there. And they can wait here and here. And there fits another one here. Also here. This is far enough away, so it doesn't block here. Okay, this should work. If this line is full and if it queues up here until here, then the trains will decide to go here. Or sometimes they will go here on their own. Toot toot. This one is running fine. This is good. Although it probably wouldn't make it up a mountain. The auto renews seem to be all finished, which causes me to have much too much money. So let's finally build this train here. Probably running cost 175. I don't even know this. It's a flatland locomotive. See here, it has lower tractive efforts than the 95. It's much cheaper. Much cheaper. A bit weaker. Reliability is okay. Well, let's buy this one again. And some coal. Ah, the first diesel. Low tractive effort, low power, nice speed. Check it later if I should replace some of my stuff. Okay, how are those two different? 28 ton, 10 ton. Let's use the gondola. Okay. Give it some orders. That's the one. Go to here, go to here, unload fully here, and start. I'm still on turbo. That's why I have so much money. I should have taken it off while I built the made some modifications here. I usually don't play with turbo. Watch some let's plays from other guys in the background while I'm playing. Can't really do this while I'm recording. So let's build one more station here. Alright, I wanted to try out what happens if there are two trains here, and I have enough money. So let's clone it immediately. Start this one. Two. And it waits nicely. Good. This looks much more realistic than the train in the small depot. I had planned to just build a larger depot, but I forgot to turn on the new graph that activates the larger depots. And ui, the high speed steam locomotive. Painted red. So it goes faster, obviously. Yes, even the old guys. This wasn't invented by Games Workshop. Let's check how our stuff is going. No, sort by cargo rating. This one has bad rating, as I can see. Let's make another one for here. Now those all short trains. No, there's a long train. Then let's make another long train. We don't really... It's already on high traffic. Okay. What's the rating? Poor. Normally means that there are much too little trains serving this one. Let's watch this for a bit. Oh yes, and these breakdowns lower the rating. Does this thing have a high breakdown rate? No. Does this one have? Not really. How mighty annoying. Let's check the next one. There's one waiting also. Sausage book. Servers. This one. This one went down a bit again. Also lots of coal. Only one train working here. Let's make a long train for here. This is a short one, yes. Let's check out this new diesel. Put the high speed off again. All cargo types. Quite strong compared to power. I don't know which one, which is a steam train I'm using for the long steam trains. I just was looking at it.